This is Jeff Zeig in Phoenix, Arizona, in my office at the office of the Milton Erickson Foundation with another five-minute tip for therapists. I want to talk, there's many things that Milton Erickson added, and basically these things were states. I think of Milton Erickson as flexibly inhabiting states and not as a person who was a technician, like he was in a state of being evocative, a state of being experiential. So when you talked with Erickson, he didn't tend to give people information. He tended to give them an experience. That could be a fragment of poetry, it could be a story, it could be a hypnotic experience, it could be a strategic directive, it could be something paradoxical. But Erickson, more than any other therapist in the history of psychotherapy, was always experiential. Now, I think that he did this by accessing a state, understanding that by him being experiential, he could help people to transpose themselves from unadaptive states to adaptive states. Another thing about Erickson was that he was involved in the process of orienting toward. Rather than informing people directly, he would tell a metaphor, a story, some symbolic experience that would orient people toward. Erickson was also in a state of acuity where he was watching closely, observing the microdynamics of human behavior and understanding the meaning. Not only that, he was using the microdynamics of communication to move other people. But Erickson was also in a state of being strategic. Being strategic is where you can envision a goal and you take a series of steps to get to that goal. So rather than jumping in to the meat and potatoes, we would serve an appetizer, move people step by step more closely to the targeted goal. Now, this presupposes that a therapist is capable of targeting a goal, because it's hard enough to keep up with communication as it's happening in a therapy room. And in this case, the therapist would be slightly ahead, targeting a goal. Now, in hypnotic language, what we learn is a yes set, which is a series of steps that move us progressively towards a goal. Let's say the goal is feeling comfort. And so rather than say to the client, feel comfortable, we would use a strategic form of communication. You're sitting here, you're resting in the chair, your body is supported effortlessly by the chair, and there's a feeling of comfort allowing yourself to just be. Now, what I need to do in order to do a yes set is to imagine where it is that I want to go and then present the target in a series of sequential steps. Now, this can be done in hypnotic language, but you don't need to use hypnosis. You can take techniques from hypnosis and use them in psychotherapy without the necessity of doing what would be considered a formal trance. So let's say that a target was bring in your spouse for the next session. So there are things that concern you, and there are concerns that others have. And there's a way in which others' concerns can have an effect both on you and the other person. And for us to really understand the totality of your situation, I think it would be best if you brought your spouse in and we met together at the next session. So then I'm envisioning the goal, I'm establishing a series of steps, oftentimes three steps, that help to move to that goal progressively. Now, once you can practice in its most simple form, a strategic form of communication, set up, set up, set up, intervene, pre-suggest, suggest. Then that becomes a state. And I'm not thinking about a technique of being strategic. I'm in the state of being strategic, and my communication just follows that pattern because this is an overlearned task. And so then it becomes easier for me when I'm communicating with friends, with family, as a teacher, to communicate in a series of strategic steps. One of the most artful aspects, unexplored artful aspects of the communication of Milton Erickson was his ability to be strategic. It wasn't based in a technique, it was based in a state in which he inhabited. I know that's a little strange to think of being strategic as a state, but I think that the state is the mother of the technique, and that by practice you can recognize, now I'm in the state of being strategic, just like you could recognize now I'm in the state of being motivated or curious or connected. This is Jeff Zeig, Phoenix, Arizona, office of the Milton Erickson Foundation, with another 5-minute therapy tip.
We are a jealous animal. We were built millions of years ago to form pair bonds to rear our young. And indeed, along with the evolution of pair bonding, 97% of mammals do not pair up to rear their young. People do. We are a pair bonding species.
But you're absolutely right. Sometimes what's going on is that the client is pursuing us because they want us to feel that what's going on inside of them is that they're scared or that they're lonely and they're not hearing enough from us.
I affirm your otherness.
I affirm your otherness.
I advocate your otherness.
I
adore your otherness. Who are we? We are wonderful, and that is the truth.
I have a question for you all. You ready? What's up with men? What is going on with men?
Easy to focus on the content of the problem or the behavior and miss the whole developmental piece that's going on. And then when it's not addressed, the couple may go away and things may be better for a little while, but it's not sufficient to sustain change over time.
Saying what I don't want feels more powerful than saying what I do want. Can you see the difficulty in getting them to express proactive goals?
The differences are amplified. This person says they want a lot, they can't want that much, they pick this guy. They just want a little more. A little more, but don't be fooled. They're cut from the same cloth.